apartment, or else order Toby to be harnessed and drive off to see a neighbor. Madam, what is it?
He was so fond of Toby. He used to ride on to the Portuguese and the Vlasovs. How well he could ride. Oh, grace there was in his figure when he pulled at the reins with all his strength. Do you remember? She was helping the stables to give Toby an extra feed of oats today.
Yes, madam.
Who's that? Tell them I'm to see Kelly.
Yes, madam.
You see, Nicholas. Oh, well, I can love and forgive. My love will die out with me. Oh, aren't you ashamed? I am a good and virtuous wife. I have locked myself in and will be true to you till death. You deceived me, had aroused me, left me alone for weeks on end.
Madam, somebody is here. They want to speak to you. He's in the dining room.
Didn't you tell him since the death of my husband, I've stopped receiving?
Yes, but he says it's very important.
Very well, ask him in. What manners? How these people annoy me. What do I want? Why should they disturb my peace? No. I should see that I have to go to a convent after all.
You women are too fond of talking. I would be honored to present myself. I am Grigory Stepanovich Smirnov, landowner and retired lieutenant of artillery. I'm compelled to disturb you on a very pressing affair.
What do you want?
Well, your late husband, with whom I had the honor of being acquainted, died in my debt for 1,200 rubles on two bills of exchange, so I've got to pay the interest on the mortgage due tomorrow. I've come to ask you, my lady, to pay me the money today.
Oh, what was my husband in debt to you for?
He used to buy oats from me.
Oh, don't forget, give Toby an extra feed of oats. If my husband dies in debt to you, then I shall surely repay you. The day after tomorrow, my steward returns from town, and I'll give him instructions to sell your account then. You must excuse me, but today's actually exactly 7 months since the death of my husband. I'm in a state of mind which prevents me from paying money matters any of my attention.
And I'm in a state of mind which, if I don't pay the interest due tomorrow, will force me to make a graceful exit from this life feet first. They'll take my estate.
You'll have the money the day after tomorrow.
I don't want the money the day after tomorrow. I want it today.
You must excuse me. I can't pay you today.
You mean to say you can't pay me?
I can't.
Is that the last word you've got to say?
Yes, the last.
The last word, absolutely your last?
Absolutely.
Thank you so much.
Mm-hmm.
I'll make a note of it. And then the people want me to keep calm. I meet a man on the street and he asks me, why are you always so angry, Grigory Stepanovich? Oh, but how on earth am I not to get angry? I mean, I want the money desperately. I rode out early yesterday morning and called on all my debtors, and not a single one of them paid up. I mean, I was just about dead after it all, slept goodness knows where in some flea bagged in. At last, I get here, 17 versts from home, and hope to get something, and I am received by you with a state of mind. How am I not to get angry?
I distinctly said, my steward will pay you when he returns from town.
What have I to do with your steward? I didn't come to your steward, but to you.
Excuse me, sir. I am unaccustomed to such a tone of voice. I'll hear no more.
A state of mind. 7 months since the death of my husband. Must I pay the interest or mustn't I ask you? Suppose your husband is dead and you've got a state of mind and nonsense of that sort, and your steward's gone away somewhere. Oh, devil take him! What do you expect me to do? Do you think I can fly away from my creditors in a balloon or what? Or do you expect me to run my head through a brick wall? I call on one day. He isn't at home. Another has hidden himself. Another and I nearly got into a violent row. Another has bowel issues. And this woman has a state of mind? No one wants to pay me. I'm much too gentle with them. Well, just you wait. You'll find out what I'm like. I shan't let you play about with me. I don't wonder. He isn't at home. Oh, my insides are quivering with anger. I can't even breathe. Oh, my word, I even feel sick. Woman!
gunpowder than have to talk to one of those poetic creatures. I can't even look at them from a distance without breaking out into a cold sweat out of sheer anger. I can't look at them.
Madam is ill and will see no one.
Get out! Really? Well, I'm gonna sit here and shall stay until I get my money. You can be ill for a week. I'll stay for a week. Ill a year? I'll stay a year. You don't get out of here with your dimpled cheeks and your widow's weeds. I know those dimples. Nobody pays up. I slept badly. And on top of everything else, here's a bit of flopping morning with a state of mind. How angry I am. Woman! Glass of vodka. I do say, I look a mess. I mean, dust all over, boots unwashed, unkept, unclean, straw on my waistcoat. The lady may well have taken me for a brigand. It's rather impolite to come into a drawing room in this state, but it can't be helped. I didn't come here as a visitor, but as a creditor. And there's no dress specially prescribed for creditors.
You allow yourself to go very far, sir.
Who are you talking to? Shut up! Get out!
The devil's come to stay. Bad news that brought him.
How angry I am. So angry that I could grind the whole world to dust. Woman! Woman! Woman!
Sir, in my solitude, I have grown unaccustomed to the masculine voice, and I can't stand shouting. I must ask you to not disturb my peace.
Pay me my money and I'll go.
I told you perfectly plainly. My steward will pay you the day after tomorrow.
Want it today. If you don't pay me today, I'll have to hang myself tomorrow.
What if I haven't got the money today? You're so strange.
Then you can't pay me.
I can't.
Fine then. Fine. You're not gonna pay me? That's fine. I'll stay here. I'll stay here all the time. I ask you, have I got to pay the interest on my mortgage due tomorrow or not? Or do you think I'm doing this for a joke?
Please don't shout. This isn't a stable.
I didn't ask you about a stable, but whether I've got to pay the interest on my mortgage due tomorrow or not.
You don't know how to talk to women.
I do know how to behave before women.
You don't. You're a rude, ill-bred man. Decent people don't talk to a woman like that.
Oh, well, how do you want me to talk to you? Madam, pardon me. I am a rude, ill beast of a man. Such lovely weather today, and how well you look in mourning.
That's silly and rude.
Silly and rude? I don't know how to behave before women. Madam, in my time, I've seen more women than you've seen sparrows in yours. I fought duels on account of them. There was a time when I played the fool, scented myself, used honeyed words, wore jewelry, made beautiful vows. I used to love, to suffer, to sigh at the moon. I loved passionately, mad in every blessed way, double taping. But now, you must excuse me. I've had enough. Passionate eyes, ruby lips, dimpled cheeks, timid breathing, the whispers. I wouldn't give a brass farthing for it now, madam. Present company always accepted. All women, great or little, are insincere backbiters, envious liars to the marrow of their bones. Vain, unreasonable, you look into her soul and you see a common crocodile. Tell me truthfully, have you ever seen a woman who is sincere, faithful, and constant? No, of course not. Only freaks and old women are faithful and constant. You'll need a white woodcock or a cat with a horn sooner than you would a constant woman.
Then, according to you, who is faithful and constant in love? Is it the man?
Yes, the man.
The man. What an idea. I'll tell you, of all the men I knew, the best was love letters, and not from me. And when he was alive, he'd leave me alone for weeks on end, betraying my trust, wasting my money, making fun of my feelings. And despite all that, I loved him and was true to him. Even in death, I am true to him, shutting myself forever within these four walls, wearing these beads to my very end.
Weeds? Oh, as if I don't know why you wear this black domino of a dress and bury yourself between these four walls. It's so mysterious, so poetic. When some junker staggers past your window, he'll think, oh, there lives the mysterious Tamara. For the love of her husband, bury yourself between four walls. We know these games.
How dare you speak to me like that?
You may have buried yourself alive, but you haven't forgotten to powder your face.
How dare you say these things to me?
Please don't shout. I'm not your steward.
I'm not the one shouting. It's you. Please leave me alone.
Pay me my money, and I'll go.
I shan't give you a farthing just to spite you. Get out!
And I have not the pleasure of being either your husband or your fiancé. So please, don't make scenes. I don't like it.
He sits! So you sit!
I do.
Please, get out.
Give me my money. God, I am angry!
I won't talk to impudent scoundrels. Leave. Aren't you coming?
No.
No?
No.
Fine. Luca, show this gentleman out.
Sir, would you mind leaving as she asks? You
woman! Who are you talking to? I'll chop you into pieces!
Oh, dear little fuck! Oh, my gosh!
More polite?
You are a boar. A coarse bear.
What? What did you say?
I said you're a boar. A
bear.
And do you think that you're one of those polite creatures you can insult me with impunity, huh? We'll find out.
Do you think, just because you have a large fist and a bull's throat, that I'm scared of you?
Pistols. Pistols. We'll find it out. I don't care if you are a woman,
bear.
What a softer sex. Oh,
bear.
Indeed.
Bear.
It's about time we got rid of the prejudices that only men need pay for their insults. If you want equality of rights, you can have it. We're going to fight it out.
With pistols? Very well. My husband had some pistols. What pleasure it would give me to put a bullet into your thick head.
I'll put her down. I'll put her down like a chicken. I'm not a little boy or a sentimental puppy, and I don't care if she is a woman, one of the softer sex. Here, the sexes are equal.
Dear sir, do go away. You scare your health to death, and now you want to shoot her?
She wants emancipation, equal rights, all that. Here, the sexes are equal. Oh, but what a woman. I'll put a bullet into your thick head, huh? Oh, how she read it, how her cheek showed. She accepted my challenge. My word, she is a woman, a real woman. That's the kind I can understand. Not a sour-faced jelly bag, but fire, gunpowder, a rocket. I'm
dear,
sorry to have to kill her.
Dear sir, you go away.
Absolutely like her, absolutely. Even though her cheeks are dimpled, I still like her. I'm almost ready to go let the tech go. And I'm not angry any longer. A wonderful woman.
Well, here are the pistols, but before we fight, you must show me how to fire. I've never held a pistol before.
Oh, Lord have mercy and save her. I'm gonna go find the coachman and the gardener.
Well, you see, there are several sorts of pistols. There are mortar pistols, especially made for duels. They fire percussion. These are Smith & Wesson revolvers, triple action with extractors. These are excellent dueling pistols. They don't cost less than 90 rubles the pair. You must hold the pistol like this. Oh, her eyes. Her eyes. What an inspiring woman.
Like this?
Yes, like this. Then you cock the trigger and take aim like this. hold your head back a little, and then put your arm out properly, like that, yes. And then you pull this little thing with your finger, and that's it. The great thing is to keep cool and aim steadily, and try not to jerk your arm.
Very well. Well, it's impolite to shoot in your room. Let's go out to the garden.
Come along, but I warn you, I'm going to fire in the air.
No, you don't get out of it that easy. I shan't have any pleasure until I put a bullet into that forehead. That forehead that I hate so much. You afraid?
Yes. Yes, I'm afraid.
You lie. Why don't you fight?
Well, because I like you. Listen, are you still mad? Look, I'm devilishly annoyed, but do you understand it? How can I express myself? Look, the fact is that, it's like this. Is it my fault that I like you? I mean, fine, okay, I like you, right? Do you understand? I almost love you. Seen one like you before in my life. That's it. I'm done for. I'm lost. I'm falling into a mousetrap like a mouse.
Stay away.